Welcome once again to my official YouTube channel Biology to Fingers. I am Ajay, welcoming you to all, and good morning to all of you. And we all set to start with here menstrual cycle part number 2. Up till now we have discussed all those 4 phases in very brief. So now it's time for the graphical representation and just to represent various kind of hormones those are related. So we all set, and we will just divide all these phases in very simple manner to understanding purpose. That may be slight different with your NCERT, but here the main motive is here that your concept should be clear, so you will be easily able to just find out which hormonal level is high and which one is lowest, what kind of certain kind of changes takes place in uterus as well as in the ovary. So for convenience in the study, we are going to divide this cycle into 3 phases here, and we will just understand this cycle into 3 phases. First one is, we will see here changes in the uterus. So we will observe changes in the uterine wall. So what kind of certain changes in the uterine wall will takes place, we will discuss here. Or we can say that uterine changes. So we can write it here, uterine changes or changes in the uterine wall. So we will discuss it here. By this manner. So this was the first. In the second step, we are going to just observe which kind of hormones are released by the ovaries. So here, ovarian hormone. So in the first step we will see certain kind of changes in the uterus. In the second step we will just observe various kind of hormones that are released by the ovaries. And in the last step we will observe what kind of certain changes in the case of ovaries. So let's we will just quickly recap changes here in the ovary. So we will observe here changes in the ovary, and we will here discuss about the, I am erasing it here, topic is here what, menstrual cycle part 2, and we will just keep here pituitary gland and their changes. So here pituitary gland is here. So we will also observe certain kind of hormones released by the pituitary gland. So as you know that in the beginning there is no level or very low level of progesterone hormone. Why there is very low level of progesterone hormone? Because this cycle is just started, and at that time the level of estrogen is very high, and under the influence of that hormone the primary follicle will develop and forms the graafian follicle, and when graafian follicle will rupture, it forms corpus luteum, then progesterone will release. So in the beginning there is very low level of what, we can write here, this one is very low level of progesterone. तो यहाँ पे जो आपको लाइन दिख रही है ये क्या है, प्रोजेस्टेरॉन. दिस लाइन इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग प्रोजेस्टेरॉन हॉर्मोन. And under the very low level of progesterone hormone, what will change, what kind of change takes place in the uterine wall? Here the lining will breaks and known as menstruation. So under the very low level of progesterone hormone, the endometrial lining will breaks and it comes out as a blood and mucus. Hence we can write it here menses. Here what, menses. And this phase this phase is known as what, menstrual phase. So this one is what, menstrual phase, where the endometrial lining of the uterus got breaks. So we can divide it here This is the phase number one. So this is the phase number one in which there is very low level of progesterone hormone, and also we can observe it here. Second hormone, that is what estrogen. We will also observe second hormone estrogen, and the level of estrogen is also very very low is here. So low level of progesterone and estrogen will act as a stimulus for the pituitary gland. So progesterone करेगा क्या है, it will stimulate the pituitary gland to release FSH. Now the low level of progesterone and estrogen act as a stimulus for the pituitary gland and stimulate the pituitary gland, that now you release the next hormone, that is FSH. So now FSH hormone is just releasing. So due to that FSH hormone, what kind of changes takes place in ovary? As you know that this is primary follicle. Now cell will grow. This become a large in size. Again, size will be increases, and ultimately it will forms Graafian follicle. So this ultimately forming Graafian follicle. So here Graafian follicle is formed. So these are the changes in the what ovary under the influence of FSH. So here under the influence of FSH, the lining, or we can say that in the ovary, primary follicles develop into Graafian follicles. So this structure is known as what? Graafian follicle. So now this Graafian follicle will release there will be release of estrogen hormone. So now this is the level of estrogen hormone, this line that we mention here there was very low level of estrogen, here the level of estrogen got increased. So as we discuss here, uterine wall just here breaks, and due to release of FSH, now this uterine wall will become thicker. So now this become thicker. It become 2 to 3 millimeter thick, and this phase is known as follicular phase. So this is what follicular phase. We will again draw a line here. So this was the phase number 2, this was the phase number 1, this is now phase number 2. And here, as you know, the level of estrogen is very high. Now then what will take place? High level of estrogen. Now this will stimulate, high level of estrogen will stimulate pituitary gland, that you just increase the secretion of, it just increase the secretion of LH and decrease the secretion of FSH. तो यहाँ पे होता क्या है, FSH का secretion, sorry LH का secretion increase हो जाता है और FSH का secretion क्या हो जाता है, डिक्रीज हो जाता है. तो यहां से ड्यू टू हाई लेवल ऑफ एस्ट्रोजन द लेवल ऑफ LH विल इंक्रीज, बिकॉज दिस विल एक्ट एज अ स्टिमुलस फॉर द पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड. नाउ यू हैव टू रिलीज द LH हार्मोन. सो हियर वी हैव इंक्रीज द लेवल ऑफ LH एंड वी हैव डिक्रीज द लेवल ऑफ FSH. So what will take place next? Now this graafian follicle under the influence of this hormone, that is what? LH will rupture. Now graafian follicle is rupturing here and it releases secondary oocyte, and this structure is known as what? Corpus luteum. This one is what? Corpus luteum. And here, as we discuss, here egg is released, that's why this is known as ovulation. This is known as what? Ovulation. So ovulation now takes place under the influence of LH hormone. So here the level of LH hormone is very high. So we can also consider it here in the beginning, or you can say that in the starting the level of LH was very very low, and here the LH is very very low, but here the level of LH is very very high, and after ovulation the level of LH will falls. So this one is known as LH surge. So this line is representing estrogen, this one is representing progesterone, and this one is representing LH. So we are considering here three hormones. So the level of progesterone is here again low, low, low level, low, very low. And now, as you know, corpus luteum will release what? Progesterone. So here corpus luteum is releasing progesterone hormone. That's why we can say that now the level of progesterone will here increase. And as you know that if fertilization takes place, then the level of progesterone will be same. And if fertilization not takes place, then this one, this corpus luteum will changes into this one is known as what? Corpus albicans. So if fertilization takes place, then this structure will continue to release the progesterone hormone and the graph will be like this. And if fertilization not takes place, then corpus luteum will change into corpus albicans and the level of progesterone will falls. Then what kind of change here? This one is if in the we can write in the case of fertilization, and this is in the case of no fertilization. If fertilization takes place, the level of progesterone will remain same, and if fertilization not takes place, the level of progesterone will fall. And what will be the impact of the other hormone? Estrogen level will again, if fertilization not takes place, then the level of estrogen will be high, and if fertilization takes place, the level of estrogen will be low. So we can make it here. Here we are just making the level of estrogen, and we will come here, and if fertilization takes place, it will remain same, and if not, it will falls. Let's come to the progesterone. As we mentioned here, the level of progesterone, this line, it will be high when if fertilization is there. If fertilization takes place, then there will be this one, and if fertilization not take place, this one. And what about LH? The level of LH was very low, here the level of LH is very high, and again this one will falls. So this line is for LH. This one is just simply for estrogen, and this one is simply that is this one is estrogen, and this line is just for progesterone. So all these are the hormones. And now let's come to the uterine lining. Under the influence of these, the uterine lining will be become thicker, up to 3 to 5 mm thick. And if fertilization takes place, then zygote will be fixed here in these lining, and if fertilization not take place, these lining will be again breaks. So this is all about the certain kind of hormones and their regulation and graphical representation of our menstrual cycle. Let's quickly recap. These are the changes in the uterine wall. These are the certain kind of ovarian hormone. We can just make it here in the case of pituitary gland. And this LH is, as you know, that released by pituitary, not by the ovary. So you have to remember that LH is released by the word pituitary, not by the ovary. But we have just mentioned here the level of that hormone also. When the level of estrogen and progesterone is very low, as I mentioned in the beginning, when the level of progesterone and estrogen is very low, in that case the lining of uterus will break and comes out as a blood and mucus. So we have just mentioned here menses, or that is known as menstruation, or the phase number 1, menstrual phase. And this level, low level of progesterone and estrogen will act as a stimulus for the pituitary gland, and now pituitary gland will release FSH, and under the FSH, these are the primary follicles develops into graafian follicle. So this was the phase number 2, when from primary follicle graafian follicle is formed, and at this stage these follicles will release estrogen hormone. That's why the level of hormone of estrogen that is mentioned here is very high. And in that phase, under the influence of that FSH and estrogen, we can say that the endometrial lining will start the repairing work. That's why it is becoming thicker and 2 to 3 mm thick here. And this was the phase number 2, follicular phase. And now high level of estrogen will stimulate the pituitary gland, that now you lower the secretion of FSH and increase the secretion of LH. It means that पहले क्या हुआ कि लो लेवल था प्रोजेस्टेरोन का, तो उसमें स्टिमुलेट किया पिट्यूटरी को कि अब आप FSH को रिलीज करिए. अब जब FSH रिलीज हुआ, वहाँ पे फॉलिकल्स डेवलप हो गए. फॉलिकल्स के डेवलप होने के बाद जब वहाँ पे रिलीज होना स्टार्ट होगा एस्ट्रोजन हार्मोन, और एस्ट्रोजन हार्मोन का लेवल जब बढ़ गया, फॉलिकल्स रिपेयर हो गए, तब अब ये जो हाई लेवल है एस्ट्रोजन का, ये फिर से स्टिमुलेट करेगा पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड को कि अब आप FSH को रिलीज करना बंद कर दीजिए और रिलीज करना स्टार्ट करिए LH को. सो नाउ हियर द LH secretion got increased and FSH secretion got decreased. So under the high concentration of LH, I have mentioned here, this is the high level of LH. Under the high level of LH, there will be ovulation. So यहाँ पे बेटा क्या हो रहा है? This is what? Ovulation. And ovulation simply takes place on the 14th day. So we can mention it here, on the 14th day. This one is of simply 1 to 5, and this one is 10 to 12, and this one is on 14th, and this one is of 15th to 28th. Okay, so now up till now we have discussed LH secretion got decreased, FSH secretion got decreased. Now this graafian follicle ruptures, releasing the secondary oocyte or egg, and ovulation takes place. And now if fertilization takes place, this structure that was remaining after the release of egg was known as corpus luteum and releasing the progesterone hormone. तो अगर egg बाहर आया graafian follicle को rupture करने के बाद, जो structure बचा वो था graafian follicle, sorry वो था आपका corpus luteum. फिर से देख लीजिए, यहाँ तक graafian follicle था, जब LH का secretion बढ़ा, FSH का secretion decrease हुआ, तो ये जो graafian follicle थी ये rupture हो गई, and after rupturing it released the egg. So egg release करने के बाद जो structure बचा वो क्या था? Corpus luteum. So इस egg का अगर fertilization हो गया तो corpus luteum लगातार release करता रहेगा progesterone hormone. अगर यहाँ पे egg का fusion नहीं हो पाया तो ये जो corpus luteum है ये corpus albicans में change हो जाएगा. उस condition में progesterone का level down हो जाएगा. अगर fertilization हुआ तो progesterone का level high रहेगा दिस लाइन, अगर फर्टिलाइजेशन नहीं हुआ तो प्रोजेस्टेरोन का लेवल डाउन होगा, और अगर प्रोजेस्टेरोन का लेवल डाउन हुआ तो ये लाइनिंग फिर से टूटेगी, और अगर प्रोजेस्टेरोन का लेवल बना रहा तो ये लाइनिंग टूटेगी नहीं और वहाँ पे प्रेगनेंसी हो जाएगी. So because as you know, progesterone is pregnancy maintaining hormone. तो अभी तक हमने यहाँ देखा कि LH का secretion बढ़ा, FSH का घटा, graafian follicle rupture हुई and बाहर आया, and बाहर आने के बाद जो structure बचा वो था corpus luteum. Corpus luteum ने progesterone hormone को release करना start किया. अगर इस egg का fertilization हो गया तो progesterone का level high रहेगा. अगर इस egg का fertilization नहीं हुआ तो progesterone का level down हो जाएगा और जो corpus luteum है वो corpus albicans में change हो जाएगा. And what effect of that is here? Again, endometrial lining become thicker and thicker under the influence of those LH hormones. So we have mentioned it here in the beginning. देखिए आप यहाँ से देख सकते हैं, estrogen and progesterone was very low. Here, these follicles releasing the estrogen, hence the level of estrogen increased, but level of progesterone remains same. Here, the level of estrogen same, and ultimately it falls, and the level of progesterone if pregnancy takes place increase, if not decrease. Here I have mentioned LH. In the beginning the level of LH was very less, and at the time of stimulation by the estrogen the LH is released in maximum amount forming the LH surge, and in the beginning it also falls. So these are the changes that takes place in the uterine wall. In the beginning God breaks, here repairing, and here become thicker and thicker. So this was all about the menstrual cycle. If you have any queries, any doubt, you can leave in the comment box. If you like the video, press the like button, and you can also subscribe the channel, and you can also share this video with your friends. That's why they will also benefit. That's for today. Thank you very much for watching the video. Jai Hind. Have a nice day.